بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وعلى من تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. All praise is due to Allah. We praise Him, seek His aid and ask His forgiveness. We seek refuge in Allah from the evils of ourselves, evils of our actions. Whomsoever Allah guides, none can misguide. Whomsoever Allah misguides, none can guide. I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship except for Allah alone, having no partner. And I bear witness that Muhammad is a slave and messenger. To proceed, verily the best of talks is the book of Allah, and the best of guidance is the guidance of His messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Verily the most evil of all matters are the ones innovated, for every newly innovated matter is an innovation, and every innovation is a misguidance. And every misguidance in religion will lead to the hellfire. First of all, I do apologize for coming late. Reason behind that my car, something wrong with it. I had to call a mechanic all the way from Luton. Alhamdulillah, I got it working and I'm here. I'm going to be talking about a very serious topic. That is a topic that everybody, if he hears about it, he should be shivering. If he hears about it, he should be preparing himself. The thing that should be bothering everybody, that moment when he's in his own, is in the grave, and it's pitch dark, nobody's with him, no wife, no children, no companions, no friends, he's on his own. And that hole, you could be living in it for a long, long time. This is the time where the scholars call it the barzakh, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well in the Quran addressed it, وَمِن وَرَائِهِمْ بَرْزَخٌ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. That barzakh, which represents the period which we'll be talking about it. And before I go ahead, I would like to talk about the journey of the person before he enters that barzakh life. And then we'll be talking about the punishment of the grave. We're going to talk about the blessings of the grave. We're going to talk about how the person can save himself from the punishment of the grave, and who are the people who are being saved from the punishment of the grave. We're going to be talking about plenty of things. And my surprise for you, inshallah, that there's a recording that took place in an area called Siberia, and I think and I believe everybody knows about it. That is, it was recorded, and some of the scholars, they said, it looks like this is the sound of the people who are being punished in the grave. We'll be shedding light upon this at the end of our talk. So, inshallah, cling heavily to your seat. And we will start. First of all, we'll talk about the death. The person, either he is a believer or a corrupted person, but he is a Muslim, or he's a disbeliever. One of the three. A believer, a corrupted disbeliever, a corrupted believer, but or the third one is a disbeliever. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he talked about two scenarios. One comes to the believer and one comes to the last two, that is the corrupted Muslim and the disbeliever. Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one day was with his companions in a janazah of one of the people of the Ansar. Ansar are the ones who gave aid to the people who migrated from Mecca to Medina. In Baqi' al-Gharqad, the Baqi' which is well known, the graveyard, the cemetery next to the Medina's mosque, which some of you had been to. While the grave is being dug, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he sat down and he was looking at the skies, and he made it three times, and he usually does look at the skies to look at the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he looks at the earth, and he has a stick with which he pokes the land with it. Then he said, استعيذوا بالله من عذاب القبر. Seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of the grave. استعيذوا بالله من عذاب القبر. Seek refuge from the punishment of the grave. He did that three times. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من عذاب القبر. Say that as well yourself. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من عذاب القبر. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من عذاب القبر. It looks like that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was thinking about the grave, or maybe he heard some punishment of the grave. Whatever it is, the Prophet ﷺ is addressing us with something important. And what was the response of the companions? They sat down, quiet and silent, not like now. I could see, I could hear some people talking. Just like the birds can as well land on their heads because of their settled bodies. They can't move. They are sort of stuck to their seats. They're stuck to their land. They're sitting and they don't know what's going to happen now. The Prophet ﷺ is addressing them with something important. He said, "Validi al-Abdul al-Mu'min," the righteous, the believer, the slave of Allah. If he's about to die, the angels who are the ones will accompany or would come first before the angel of death will ascend, will descend upon him. They are white in their faces, glowing light, just like the sun, he says. With them the shroud from the heaven, from paradise. They will sit in a way that he could see them. The people who are around the person who is dying, they can't see them. They are awaiting the angel of death. And by the way, he's called the angel of death. It is not called Uzra'il. Uzra'il is a name given to us by the Torah, which has been forged, some of it. So his name for us is Malakul Maut, that is, the angel of death. He comes to him and he sits beside his head. And he says, "Ayyatuha nafsu tayyibah, O good righteous soul, al-mutma'inna, settled soul, ukhruji ila maghfirati min Allah, come out to the mercy, to the forgiveness of Allah, wa ridwan, that is, and the pleasure of Allah." قال فتخرج كتسيل كما تسيل القطرة من فيه السقاء. It would come out just like a drop coming out from the mouth of the bottle. فيأخذها. The angel of death will take it. حتى إذا خرج روحه صلى عليه كل ملك بين السماء والأرض. When it comes out, every angel between the heavens and earth, he will invoke forgiveness, pass salutation upon this soul. وكل ملك في السماء. And every angel in the heavens, in the skies. And by the way here, before I continue, I have found that some of the English readers, they mistranslate or misunderstand or confuse themselves between the word heavens, which means as well sometimes paradise, and heavens means what? The skies. So when we say that the Prophet ﷺ saw Ibrahim alayhi salam, and he saw Adam alayhi salam, and he saw Musa alayhi salam, he saw them not in paradise, in the heavens. He saw them in the skies. What's the difference here? People, they think it's heaven because it's an English word here. Heaven means skies and it means paradise at the same time. So when I say now here, skies or heavens, I mean the skies. And when I mean paradise, I will say paradise. So if you hear the word heaven for me, it means what? The skies, not paradise. So the Prophet ﷺ said that as soon as the soul comes out, every angel in the heaven, every angel between the heaven and earth will invoke forgiveness upon the soul. And every angel will invoke that this soul would ascend from their side, from their gate. As soon as he takes the soul, the angels who are with the angel of death, they will not leave it in his hand a twinkle of an eye. They will take it, put into that shroud, and as soon as they put it into the shroud, a nice fragrance comes in, out of it. And that fragrance is the best of fragrance you could smell on the face of the earth. And they will ascend with the soul. And every time they pass by a group of angels, they will say, "Who is this righteous soul?" They say, "So and so, the son of so and so." With the best of names, he was known with it. Until they reach the heavenly sky, the heavenly, that is that the worldly heaven, that is the world heaven, the first heaven, which we haven't reached yet. They will ask for him to get inside. He will ask for permission. They will ask, "Who is this? The son of so and so." They will let him to go, and they will ask forgiveness for him until they reach the seventh heaven, the seventh sky. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would say, "Uktubu kitaba abdi fi illiyin," write the book of my slave into illiyin, into the high lofty, that is the uppers. وَمَا أَدْرَكَ مَا عِلِّيُونَ. You don't know what is عِلِّيُون. كِتَابٌ مَرْقُومٌ. This book, this record, is يَشْهَدُهُ الْمُقَرَّبُونَ, witnessed by the angels. So his record will be written there, in the up, in the seventh heavens. Then Allah would say, return him back to the earth, from which I have